Anna Tozzi, and I'm representing the University of L'Aquila in this meeting. My presentation will be integrated by key persons working in specific research teams, Professor Filippo De Monte and Gabriele Curci, who will expand in detail the items connected with the ranking. A short introduction of our university. Our university, as all universities in the world, are well committed in three main missions: teaching, research, and third mission, that is the civic engagement and engagement with the social issues. The present global challenges are calling the universities all over the world to afford and to cope with the main dangers that are just in front of us. This is particularly important in L'Aquila, for our university, because we are affording the difficult time of reconstruction of the earthquake of 2009. Now, almost all the buildings are restructured, all the activities are restarted and renovated, but the participation in WE Green Metric ranking gave us the opportunity to measure the level of attainment of our goals. University of L'Aquila makes sustainability the key point of all the, its programming. So our strategic plan is linked to the 17 Sustainable Development Goal of the United Nations and is member of the Italian Network of the University for the Sustainable Development. According to the special issue, special item, energy and climate change, the university worked with a multidisciplinary team, in particular the research center CETEMS, focusing on climate change, ranked first in Italy by ARGU 2020. The other Excel centers of use focused on disruptive technology, the other teams are very well known over the world. The good result, the good performance of Univac is due to several concurrent factors. First of all, this performance is not disjoint from the other items, the other section of the ranking, but the main principle was clear goal, clear time of attainment, and clear and very transparent corrective and integrated measures for improving and assessing the quality of the result.
Okay, my name is Filippo De Monte, and I was involved in the energy part of this document. According to the European directives, Italian law and central administration policies of sustainable development, all the lighting feature based on LED technology in three buildings of Univac campus, two new and one renovated, and also in two existing buildings. Therefore, if we calculate the ratio between the LED lamp equipped building area to the total building area, we obtain the value of 61% that falls into the green metric range of 50-75%. In addition, all the inefficient appliances installed in the renovated building, Palazzo Camponeschi, were replaced with the highest energy saving ones based on standby mode inverter technology. In addition, energy efficient appliances are also used in the new buildings of Human Science and Blocco Zero in Copito. This figure on the bottom right side shows a very high efficient air conditioning system installed at the Human Science building. Green metric question 2.2 and 2.3 related to smart building. Five buildings of Univac can be classified as smart building according to the definition of green metric 2018 that adapted the RUS indicators. In details, two of the five buildings are new buildings, two of them are renovated buildings, and just one is an existing building. So the ratio of the total smart building area to the total building area is about 90%. It is a very high value. In addition, in UNIVAC, we make use of a facility management system, very helpful, that is named InfoCAD. The monitoring and management of energy needs for space heating, space cooling, domestic hot water and air ventilation is done by using a building automation system. In particular, we use the software used in at the Human Science Building is Controlli, while the ones employed at Palazzo Camponeschi is Siemens. This grid shows the five buildings of UNIVAC that match the grid metric smart building concept. This figure shows the five buildings that are considered smart building. It is important to consider also renewable energy sources that are currently used at UNIVAC campus and are both installed at a Human Science Building. We have a photovoltaic power plant whose capacity is of about 85,000 electrical kilowatt hour per year. The plant is grid connected, and the solar thermal plant whose capacity is of about 100,000 thermal kilowatt hour per year. So we can affirm that the photovoltaic plant is able to cover at most 17% of the electricity demand. I say 17% as the energy demand response not always match each other. As regards the solar thermal plant, this is used not for domestic hot water needs, ma only for integrating the space heating and the space cooling. As regards the space cooling, we have to use an absorption cycle refrigeration machine of 45 kilowatt that is combined to the solar thermal plant. If we calculate we can affirm that the solar thermal plant is able to cover 50%, 25% of the total consumption of thermal energy. This picture is the Human Science Building, and the schematic on the left side shows the photovoltaic plant and the solar thermal plant that are combined with the radiant panel system and the heat ventilation air conditioning system. The use of electrical energy in UNIVAC is mainly for space cooling, ventilation, lighting, building automation and control, laboratory facility, as space heating and domestic hot water make in general use of natural gas. I say in general as the domestic hot water can also be obtained by using electrical boilers, as is done at Human Science Building. The figure on the left side shows the electric energy usage in three different years, 2016, 17, 18. And the same usage is given in percent on the right side figure. We can observe that in 2018 the electric energy consumption was 2% lower than the one 2016. This figure gives the electricity usage per month into different years, 2017 and 2018. It is also important to calculate to normalize the total electricity usage by means of the total number of regular students, the total number of academic and administrative staff. So if we calculate this ratio, we obtain that electrical energy consumption of 255 kilowatt hours per person, that is less than the green metric value of 279 kilowatt hour per person. If we calculate the ratio of the renewable energy production divided by the total energy usage per year, this value is a low value of 2.25% that falls into the grid metric range of 2.25%. Ma of course, we would like to install in the near future new photovoltaic plants to produce electrical energy. And according to European directive and Italian laws, our university is organizing the energy consumption through the use of a building automation system. that will be provided to each building of campus. The building automation system, the use of building automation system, allow us to reduce the electrical energy consumption 2% in 2018. Also, new and renovated buildings have only LED technology, and the total replacement of obsolete lamps is ongoing, as well as the replacement of obsolete appliances with high energy efficiency ones. Another important issue is the reduction of energy for space heating purposes, according to the Italian law that requires to meet the minimum energy performance requirements for both new and renovated buildings. An energy performance certificate is mandatory. For only new buildings, such as the one, the Human Science Building, very high efficiency systems were considered. For example, heat pumps were installed combined with radiant panels, and two renewable energy solutions were adopted.
Good morning, my name is Gabriele Curci, and I am responsible for the working group on climate change. Until this year, the university did not have an official greenhouse gas inventory. So, for the green metric of last year, we relied on the guideline of green metric, and in particular, we calculated our emissions using the factors for energy, cars, and bus provided in the carbon footprint guidelines. We estimated for 2018 about 7,000 metric tons of CO2 emission on the total emission of the year, which is below the threshold of 0.42 metric per person. This year, however, we approved the first greenhouse gas inventory, which was developed in the framework of the RUS working group. And this will allow a more accurate estimate of the greenhouse gas inventory so that the future plans could be guided by these estimates. In fact, for the greenhouse gas reduction program, we will integrate all the measures and activities that Filippo already showed in a more comprehensive plan, in particular a climate change mitigation plan, and which will also be coordinated with the climate change adaptation plan. The future and long-term target will be zero emission in 2050, as set by the European Commission. This is all for our presentation. Thanks for your attention and goodbye.